We now live in a post-GDPR world, but what does this mean for the day-to-day reality of business technology professionals? For Tech Republic and ZDNet, my name is Dan Patterson with Box VP of Compliance, Crispen Maung. Crispen, thanks a lot for your time today. Let's start with what companies need to be thinking about in terms of compliance and making sure that their internal policies kind of match external regulations.
Well, Dan, most companies should have actually gone through this already. But in regards to what companies need to do, if they've not done it, then they really need to think about how they manage the data and control data. And do they actually have the right controls and processes in place to secure the data? In addition, there's other articles out of GDPR that require sort of like operational processes to be put in place. Things like the right to be forgotten and, you know, deletion and erasure of data and those types of things. In addition, though, I think companies also need to take a look at how they're processing data or how they use data and information, because I think that's going to be one of the questions that regulators are going to start asking in the future. Not only is the data secured, not only have you actually addressed some of the, you know, process kind of articles within the requirements, but also have you and can you show how you are actually controlling the data in regards to how the data is used within your organization.
What about working with vendors? Often, in almost all cases, whether you're an SMB, startup, or enterprise company, you have to work with vendors at some level or another. How do you ensure not just that they're compliant, but that your goals are aligned in terms of compliance and data management?
Right. Once again, the obligation for you, if you're the data controller or processor or sub-processor, is to make sure that any of those suppliers or vendors that you might leverage where data may be kind of moving to those organizations is also under control. Ultimately, at the end of the day, you have responsibility for making sure those controls are in place, making sure that you actually have the legal mechanisms for that movement of data to those other locations. And really, you should actually have a fiduciary responsibility for making sure that, as I mentioned earlier, that the controls that a sub-processor may have in place truly are in place, and really that they kind of meet your bar in regards to information security and data privacy. At the end of the day, everything should be at the same level. So you're obliged or obligated, I think, to actually make sure that, you know, whatever you do as an organization is kind of transferred in equal or similar controls with any sub-supplier that you may use.
So what about those companies that may have been or put a good effort into becoming compliant but might have missed the deadline? Is there anything that they should do, other than the points you've already enumerated, is there anything that they should do to make sure that they get their house in order quickly and perhaps communicate with regulators that, hey, we're on the case, we maybe are a little behind the times?
Okay. I think I would not necessarily reach out to the regulator. I think when you look at GDPR, at the end of the day, the regulator, or the requirement to be compliant by, you know, May 25th, 2018, was really kind of a timeline by which you should have a program in place. And obviously, I think we need to recognize that some companies have difficulty putting those programs in place because they're so large, or they've not really paid too much attention until kind of like it became a serious issue. In which case, you know, I think having a program in place is important. And actually having a project in place to put a program in place is probably even more important for those companies that haven't started or have started but are not quite finished. At the end of the day, I don't think any company is finished. I think what you have to be able to show to any regulator is the fact that you do have a program in place for effective data protection. Okay. And that program is going to evolve and develop and improve over time. And I think as long as you can show a regulator that that's what you're doing and that's the kind of program you have in place and you have the right mechanisms in place, you know, in terms of addressing some of the articles like right to be forgotten and those types of things, then I think you're fairly sound in your approach. For those companies that have done absolutely nothing, I think they're probably in a worse position, if not a really bad position, to be quite honest, because you never really know when a regulator might start knocking on the door. But if you've got a partial program in place, you can show an effective program or an effective project plan for putting that program in place. I think most regulators would understand that this is an evolving thing for most organizations. And as long as you're in business, you're going to have data. You're going to have to come up against new challenges with the data. As your business moves and changes and modifies, you're going to have to change your data protection profile. So it's going to be an evolution. to me, I think, you know, the date last Friday was really the beginning of the end in regards, or the end of the beginning, sorry, in regards to, you know, putting an effective program in place for data management and data protection.
I'm so glad that you emphasized a few times there that this is an evolving process, and it really is perhaps the end of the Wild West era and the beginning of a new era. So what can companies anticipate in terms of regulation and in terms of just managing consumer data or business data going forward? Things have changed, and we're not going back to what was the status quo before the 25th of May.
Right. I think the looking forward, you know, if you've got an effective program in place, that's absolutely fantastic. But 9 times out of 10, what organizations did was focus on their internal controls from an information security perspective. And then over the last few months, a lot of them have focused on supplier relationship that we mentioned a moment ago. But I think what I can see in the future is more discussions from the regulators of how they want to determine if companies can prove, organizations can prove, that they're using the data appropriately. All right. And I think that's one of the important areas that will start to be, you know, will start to surface from the regulators in regards to things they're looking at. So the security question, you know, checkbox done. You know, everyone might have an ISO 27000 certification or have controls in place for information security that's kind of pinned to that standard. In regards to managing the supply base, then you can show evidence of that. But a lot of organizations aren't really thinking about the operational processes they need to have in place to prove that they're only using the data appropriately. And I think that's where the challenge is going to be for most organizations.